Hello friends, dictation will be started after 10 seconds at 80 word per minute. During the third 5-year plan, 16% of the national plan was allocated for the railways. Then it started reducing. In the 10th plan, it came down to 5%, and in the 11th plan, it is expected to be 6%. It means the allocation for the railways, which is the biggest public utility service in our country, is a very small fraction of the total outlay available in our plans. Who is responsible for this? Are the public to suffer for this? And will the government every year come up with proposals for raising passengers' fares or the freight structure? Only 9 months back, they came up with a proposal and raised the passenger fares. Now, they are raising the freight structure. This is putting additional burden on the people as a whole. What will be the effect on the economy in general if these rupees 320 crores are collected through this hike in the freight structure? It will have a disastrous effect on the total economy that will lead to serious inflation. If we go in for a rise in the administered prices by raising the freight structure, they say it may lessen the burden or minimize the burden on the people. Whatever it is, the fact is that the effect of this hike in the freight structure will be serious on the total economy and prices of the essential commodities are bound to go up. So, madam, I feel that the railway administration is putting additional burdens on the people several times every year. Now, coming back to the passenger traffic, I would like to mention that some trains have been introduced, but I do not know whether the minister has any experience of traveling in the second class or in ordinary trains. Besides the Rajdhani or 2 or 3 super fast trains, there are deplorable conditions in the passenger trains that are running in our country. Without light, without the minimum amenities, the passengers have to travel in a very pitiable condition, and reserved compartments are full of people who are without reservation, and people are compelled to travel in that way. Because of the shortage of accommodation, people have to travel like beasts. And without reservation, people come to reserved compartments. The reservation has also been introduced to a force. Nowadays, to make a reservation in an ordinary first class or ordinary second class has no meaning, because people would not be able to travel in their reserved seats and they will be made to stand, while others without reservation will sit there. Okay friends, thank you. Thank you for coming to my channel. Share this video for your friends so that they can also dictate. Okay, friends, thank you.